So this will be a bit of a surprise change of pace. You can make out a lot of the characters of this game based on all the little characters that show up on the cover. And so we know that you can play as Oswald, and you know that you can play as the Fairy Queen, Mercedes, and that you can play as Violet. And we've encountered all these different characters in Valkyrie's storyline. But the next one's the Pooka Prince. The new campaign we're unlocking is someone that I don't think we've actually necessarily met at all, or at least hasn't played any major role in the Valkyrie story up to now. So whatever role this is going to take is going to have a completely different perspective on the world. We'll see how it does or does not intersect. Here we go.
Cornelius, are you going to the forest again? You've changed recently. I thought you would have learned to be responsible, but you are still immature. No matter how fascinating that girl in the forest is, remember, you are a prince. Be reasonable and stop acting like a fool.
Your Majesty, the prince merely wishes to sow his wild oats while he retains his youth.
Stay out of this, you court jester.
Calling the royal sorcerer a fool is quite harsh.
Father, as I have said, 'tis no mere game or jape. My feelings are genuine.
I told you what happened to your uncle. Do you recall? Are you saying you wish to commit the same mistake? My brother loved a common girl from the village and was disowned by the king. After suffering that humiliation and fleeing the country, he fell ill.
Father, this is different. The woman I love is no low-class commoner. I do not believe she is unfit for royalty.
A kingdomless princess. What did she expect of you when you first met?
Father, please stop insulting her. You may be my father, but I will not hear her impugned.
Cornelius, I know of another princess, more beautiful, more honorable, wealthier. Let your princess of the forest know my feelings.
Regardless of what you say, my mind is made up. If you do not approve, I shall abdicate my heritage.
Cornelius, wait!
Your Majesty, the prince will eventually come to his senses. Perhaps we ought to leave him be for now.
Where am I? Where is this? Oh! What's happened to me? My body. My ears. I'm a beast. What in the world? Is this all a dream? No. This gloom. It chills me down to the bone. This is all too real. This place, it's so strange. It's entirely devoid of life here. If the stories of the Netherworld are true, then this is surely it. I have to find my way back. Back home to Titania. Must return to the princess.
Hold. descent. Are you not Titanian royalty?
Aye, so I am. I am Prince Cornelius. When I woke up, I was like this.
Cornelius, I cannot see, but I know. Yes, surely, tis you.
This fearful voice that speaks to me from the darkness. Who are you?
Even if I told you, you would not believe me. Do not approach me. My flesh is merely a banquet for maggots and other filth. If you saw my body, your very soul would tremble, and your blood freeze. Take that. You shall find it useful. As Prince of Titania, tis your responsibility. That sword may eventually make my identity known.
What do you want of me? Do you know what has happened to me?
Go now. If you do not wish misfortune to haunt you forever, aim for your home, Titania. Your destiny awaits there.
Wait!
Please go. Let me rest.
He's gone. Tis a dream. An illusion. I'm still asleep in bed. Please let it be a dream. Let me wake from this nightmare and be greeted by the sun's warming rays. But I have no choice. I must continue.
Cornelius performs nimble actions with a sword. Hold down an X during a jump to do a special attack that plunges the sword underneath. There we go. Oh, hi everyone. Don't mind me. So we still have our guard. Oh wow, he's actually pretty good with the sword. This will be a nice little moveset to experiment with. Oh, there's the down an X. We can do our own variation of the DuckTales pogo attack. Okay, fine. So that was an interesting little change of pace there. I was confused at first. I'm like, who's this blonde guy? This is supposed to be the Pooka Prince chapter, and he's not a Pooka as far as I can tell. So I've been transferred to the Netherworld. I've been conveniently given a crystal weapon, which we can absorb these crystals, the stuff that lets us level up and everything, that basic element. And we're also immediately given a father figure that doesn't agree with our actions, again, much like with the Valkyrie. And we're given what looks like a conniving wizard, much like how that one member of our army under Odin was clearly a bad guy and turned out to be a bad guy. Whoa, surprise! Based on his character design, where he looked like a horrible gnashing monster, this guy also looks like a bad guy because he looks like the conniving background character. So I'm wondering if he secretly is the one that cursed us.
I must speak with you. It is an urgent matter. Please wait for me at our usual spot. I would like to finally shake the indecisiveness I have held for so long. My love, I shall speed towards you, quick as the wind.
Prince Cornelius.
So he's in love with Velvet. Makes sense, given the characters we have options for. There's two people we know of being in the forest, but one of them is known as the Queen of the Fairies, so that the princess title would probably not be fitting. So Velvet's the clear candidate. Hi. Whoa, boob monsters. I can talk to you.
Where is it? My poison blade. Find it for me.
doesn't have arms, it has weird fish lips, but somehow has breasts where the nipples just stab through that, that dress. What a weird design. I can talk to you too?
It hurts! It hurts! The pain won't go away even if my flesh rots off! If I could only pass on from the pain, then it would briefly go away! But relief won't come!
Oh wow. That's dark. So everyone's just down here suffering forever in the Netherworld, and there are all these weird corpse monsters. And I'm cursed, seemingly. It seems like the right word for turning into a completely different creature and waking up in the Netherworld.
I have prayed for forgiveness, but there is no salvation.
Hear me, sinner. Hear my confession.
We say how much it hurts, or how apparent our greed has become. But mere words cannot do justice to the anguish I feel.
I have poison if you want. Unfortunately, I do not have a blade to coat with it.
Well, we don't have any money, really, so we're probably not going to make it very far here unless I really want a mulberry seed to start things off. Not much going to happen here. And I assume that this probably, yep, does not give me access to other characters' inventories or anything like that. So, we're off to a dark start. We'll see how this goes. So the world, this does seem to be the world map of the entire game. So every character is probably going to go from point to point around here. This time we're starting in the Netherworld.
I sense signs of life in this land, ruled by carnage and destruction. Be this a trick? Can I hope? Alas, I have naught to lose. All I feel now is resentment and hatred. I have lost any compassion I once had.
You, walking skeleton, stop right there. Who are you?
I do not remember names. Who are you, aimlessly roaming this land? What purpose do you have? Spirits and goblins shall find you and tear your tender flesh to ribbons.
What do you suggest I do?
You. Do you wish to leave here? In order to do so, 'tis necessary to receive permission from the Queen. Let me guide you to her. But in compensation for my services, I ask you to take me with you when you leave. Agreed?
How greedy of you. I cannot promise your safety.
Now come, and be quiet, or else they will gather. What are you doing? Stay close to the candle. Without light, you shall not be able to see the ghosts.
Definitely interesting to have one campaign start exactly where the previous one ended. So we have to make our way through the Netherworld once again. Hello. You shall be the first. Hey, come back here. An onion. Oh, wait, we got a collection here. Oh man, there's so many of them. Come here. They're all over the place. Right, they'd have to give me an onion pretty early on because isn't that how I make shine in the first place? That'll be a big deal. Yeah, we've got a series of collections here. For now, I should be fine. We'll see how the level's laid out. That's a problem. Don't mind me. Hello, friend. Come and get it, ghosties. Yep, there. Oh. It shouldn't be too tough. They're all level one. There we go. Come and get it. Oh, look at that animation. That's nice. He's got a proper combat roll, too, instead of the somersault. Can I just attack you? There we go. I can just attack those guys. Those dogs apparently don't have the same characteristics. Interesting. Ooh! I can still hover. So I can hover just like the Valkyrie could to an extent. Although instead of a... Where was that? There was a plant around here. I'll find that in a moment. Where was it? I heard it. You're not tricking me. There it is. Gotcha. Let's put the power stone on. Nothing else can go in that slot right now anyway. Let's see. I've heard that you can add bones to things. Let's try it with shine just to see what happens. Changes all items on the ground into something else. Right, I remember that. What if I added another one? It just gets more powerful. No. I don't have other potions yet. I could craft one with the with what I have. I'll pass for now. Any options? Nope, no options yet. So we've got a guy that wants to help us. He's willing to let us out of here, or help us out of here, but he's got his own price. It's interesting. I have my own hover ability, just like the last one did, but it definitely goes down over time. It's not the weirdly, perfectly horizontal, magical hover the other character has. He's just real good at spinning swords. Hi. Nope. Oh yes, do the pogo. That's fantastic. So to be clear, I don't have much control over what happens once I start doing this attack. It's not like the Shovel Knight attack where I can control it perfectly in midair and keep hitting the same character over and over again. You go forward at more or less a fixed rate. So it's a nice way to attack a group of characters like this for sure. In fact, it almost seems specifically designed to wipe out these kinds of groups. Ooh. Then it can be used for mid-air juggle. That's gotta come in handy. Go launch in the air and then come down on someone. Once they're in the air, it seems like they'd be more likely to be horizontally displaced and continually get hit by your attack over and over again. But we'll see. Spiral Claw. My first ability. POW cost of 30%. Forward spin dash with sword extended. Move up or down during use. Ooh, you can move around with it. Interesting. Our weapon's it's still called a cipher. So that terminology has remained consistent. Let's make the Spiral Claw more powerful right off the bat. It's my only ability, so might as well be strong. Alright. So what are we starting off with here? Spiral Claw. I may as well just map it to normal circle for now. I have no other abilities. Oh yeah, that'll come in handy. That said, because of its forward thrust, I think I'm gonna map it to forward and circle. There we go. That's definitely the button combination that comes naturally for that kind of attack. Oh yeah, that'll come in handy. Oh, hey. Calm down, you're not getting away from me. So we have a side path over here. I see you. You're not getting away. Anyone hanging out? Just a seed here and there? A few nightmare destructible bones for me to obliterate like a monster? Take that, remains of the dead. I don't need to respect you. You can't fight back. Well, some of them are fighting back, but they aren't putting up a great fight so far. Ooh. A free planting location. Might as well. These require 6 foes on, so I could actually plant both. And it would most likely be... Oh, that has 11. I'll have to contribute one of my own. Not bad, though. Right there. There we go. We've got our supply now. Alright, so these give you 2 hit points, the heal for 30. They'd be better used elsewhere, I'm sure. Can't I mix them into here? It just makes it more powerful, doesn't it? I have to actually add something else to it to make it do something, like Juggler. What if I add a healing tonic to it? Really, that doesn't make it a healing tonic. Interesting. So these are really just best for eating and nothing else. still experimenting with alchemy a little bit. Hello, friend.
I will not hand over my treasure. Eh? Why didn't you say you had money? My greed is the very reason I'm down here, but I do not regret it.
Oh, it's the same NPC from the other campaign. He says that he even has the same dialogue. Override Mulberry's Detox Charm. Oh, I can't afford these kinds of things. Alright. Let's get one of those on for our own sake. Nope, there goes all of my money. Goodbye. It was nice knowing you, money. Goodbye forever. Go ahead and equip one of these. There we go. That'll hopefully help out in this zone a bit, or future ones. See, that's just a teleport spot. I don't think we've met the wandering merchant yet. I assume that the cook's gonna be in every game. But they haven't taken a roll yet here. Ooh. Don't think I want to land in that. Seems like a bad time for all. Careful now. Surprised my other character never encountered this spot. Being an animal creature that has a spin that helps me hover definitely gives me Tails vibes from this character. This game is much better than any of the Sonic games, though. Hi! Nice to meet you. That's a damaging attack, isn't it? Wow. Wouldn't expect it to be that damaging, honestly. Oh. That was not the right move in that situation, but it worked out somehow. Okay. I see a bunch of you guys over here, and I feel like I should respond in kind. Double Cyclone! New specialty, apparently. Oh, where are you going? You gonna turn to a bird again? Nope, there it goes. At least there's no exposed floor around here. So far I don't have to worry about there being poison to fall into. Hey, carrot here. Yep, don't want to play with your fire, sir. Aw, tragedy. Let's get out of that attack range. I saw you charging stuff, I knew it was coming. Volcano, ooh. Oh, he just likes to execute people, and that somehow gives him power. Because over the process of him executing them, attacks happen. Ow. Oh, ran out of pow. My bad. Hey, sir. Let it happen. It's okay. You're almost down. You don't need to fight anymore. You fought for so long, but now it's time to rest. You can almost come up with an internal canon to say that all these characters are weak because I'm fighting them after Gwendolyn just went through and weakened them all, but I'm sure this is probably an overlapping timeline, so this probably is happening approximately when Gwendolyn's story was starting. So I think they all have, I think all the stories kind of happen in parallel, so that explanation will not work. The real reason is video games! Because just people get more and less powerful as time goes on, just within their respective campaigns. Kind of like how Dynasty Warriors has multiple campaigns and you can do different fights at different times in the campaign. And based on which of the six battles it happens in, that'll affect the difficulty. Come over here, Fozon. Goodbye. Oops. Oh yeah, that's effective, that mid-air combo. It's like an anti-air attack. Give me your contents. They are giving me all sorts of shine. Can I mix shine in my shine for more shine? That'll help with some inventory space, huh? Now it's a super shine. Let's see, higher damage, stuns the enemy more, longer duration, but also just a bit of inventory conservation. Oops. Mixed up my buttons a little bit. Press down and X instead of down and attack. There we go. That goes somewhere. There's the boss way at the end. Seems like down is the logical path to take here, to have the least backtracking. So that's my... When I used to hold square and hit forward to do a dash attack with Gwendolyn, that would shoot out like a torpedo and had great mobility. This is my new replacement, is this thing that looks vaguely Hyrulean. It'll come in handy as an attack, but it's not quite as evasive as the other one used to be. Hello! things are really gross. They also laugh at you using a stock sound, which is a little unusual to hear that kind of stock sound usage. I wonder if they recycled it from the original game. Because around the time Odin Sphere 1 came out, the original game came out, it probably would have been more likely to use heavy stock sounds in your video games. Just a different budget scale over time. It's always a surprise to hear really noticeable stock sounds in a game, even though they're always going to show up somewhere. Especially those goddamn various yells and screams that are always so noteworthy. Interestingly, this is a three-hit combo, the dashes. He does a horizontal strike, then an upward strike, and then a downward strike. And then the combo ends and you have to reset, and there's like a lag between that and your next input. Let's see, so this is supposed to be able to go up and down? Oh yeah. You can really move around with that. That could come in handy. Hi! Don't mind me. How'd that work out for you guys, huh? I think I might have cleared the room already. Is that all you guys got? Yep, that's it. That's all they got for me. Upwards we go. He's got fantastic control of his body and is very agile for somebody who's had this body for like a few minutes as opposed to growing up with it for 20 years. You think he'd be clumsy, all things considered. Maybe it's magic. I could plant something here. What do you have again? 11? It's really just the one. I'll plant a couple of them. We can have a mass eating moment in a moment. There we go. Come to me. Ooh, there's also a little... There's somebody hiding in there. Even more plants for the pile. I think somebody was pointing out that like this is like a vegetarian's nightmare because... That's the same NPC again. This game is filled with a... They're saying it's a vegetarian's nightmare because all of the enemies in this game... not all the enemies. All the plants in this game are alive. And half the things that you plant, like... Some of them just give you, like, living creatures instead of plant life. And it's like a weird nightmare where everything's kind of an animal all the time, and you have to kill the plants because they run away and have self-preservation and stuff like that instead of just being, a plant. We're actually filling up our inventory again. I could just go ahead and just chow down. Yummy, yummy. Let's pump up that experience bar, huh? Yep. Time to stop being such a low level. It takes so little experience at this point to level up. It's great. That number really ramped up by the time we were at the end of Gwendolyn's campaign and reaching level 50-ish. Let's put some bones in there because we have so many of them. Maybe even some shines. There we go. That'll help us store more. Ooh. Didn't even mean to do that. Lucky me. There we are. Friends? Friends. Murder friends. I'd prefer not to fall in there, so I'm gonna stay over here. Don't mind me. Oh, that's bad for me. Alright, we landed on land. That was convenient. Things just barely worked out. There we go. Anyone else? I see you over there. Oh! Hide underground. It's behaving like a wheel skeleton. Oop. Here they are. Yeah, they're happy to see me, aren't they? Wow. Okay, bad spot to be. There we go. Much better. Much improved, all things considered. Wow. They're clustering. Come here. It's weird that you can't attack them when they're in cute mode. Like, they're clearly enemies. They must just actually be translucent, because surely my character's not being fooled by them. There we go. Ooh, what's down here? We got through that alright. We took some damage, which we'll have to worry about a little bit, but otherwise we're good. A little bit of poison here and there. Never hurt anyone. Well, hurt a lot of people. Poison's bad, kids, don't worry. Well, do worry. That was rather unfortunate for you guys. Went down in an instant. You got more hiding over here? This little... Alright, well, that's that loose end covered. It's the path back to where we came from. Uh-oh. If there's any baddies around here, we're gonna... Yep, that's the guy we want. Okay. Oh, there's the bad guy. You're bound to be around here somewhere. They're going down a lot faster, though. Those level ups seem to have paid off significantly. More bones for the pool. Hey! How many of you are there? We done? I think we might be done with them now. All clear. It's always a joy to move with these characters. But there were various dashes and their mid-air like hover moves and everything like that. There we go. Oh! Oh, wow. Two strikes. This must be a lower level room than the last one that I was in. Those guys at least took a combo. These guys are going down in a quick one, too. Gotta grab that silver. Don't want to fall behind. You gotta be competitive in this here market. Oh, I missed one. Oh. There it is. Found that one on the map. I didn't actually spot it when I was walking by. Hi. Oh, hi. He's not happy to see me at all. Oh, well, that was a waste. There we go. Ew, Beetlejuice is back. All right. Where you at? Where you at, buddy? I'm here. Oh, there you are. Whoa. Wow. Surprise crit. Did a surprise crit that had an overhead swing component that just completely wiped out my opponents that were... I didn't even know about until the attack was already happening, so that was pure luck, that little kill we got there. There we go. Any more? Nope. All clear. Things are going pretty straightforward here. That looks like it's supposed to be the toughest... No, not, I guess not the toughest battle here. There was a 4-star back there, too. We'll see what they have. They have a ring waiting for me. A mid-boss. It's Oogie Boogie! I missed you. And your stock sounds. One health bar down. Hey, buddy. Good time for Volcano, right? There's some damage. How about a Whirlwind? Oh, he disappeared, didn't he? Good time to clear out the neighbors, though. There we go. He doesn't seem to appreciate the attention he's getting right now. If I were to guess. Ow. Wow, Whirlwind's no joke in this context. That took a serious chunk out of him. One more hit. There we go. And the Boogie has been defeated. Now I am the Funk Master. Shield ring has got to come in handy, right? I got a couple of POWs. 5% chance to nullify damage taken is probably a good choice. Let's get out of the poison zone first. I'll keep the poison item on while we're in this zone. But soon, perhaps. Alright, goodbye, Boogie. I feel like these enemies are going down faster than they did for the Valkyrie. I felt like the low-level bosses were... slower kills as the Valkyrie, but it could just be because I'm more experienced. Like, I mean, I'm like 500% more experienced at this game than I was when I played the first Valkyrie level and had no idea what I was doing. And the fact that I'm actually using attack potions probably doesn't hurt. Alright, boss. We're on our way. Hey. 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 Can't get away from me. Shame on you. Think you can run from me. Ain't having none of that. No! Death to all sentient fruit. Murder the sentient fruit.
What an odd blade. It is frighteningly sharp. It must be a magic sword.
Indeed it is. A sword made from the jewels, selfishly stolen from here by the dwarves. Sinful bandits who have blundered into the netherworld while alive. Ask yourself how you came to hold that sword. If you wish for the Queen's compassion, be a dear and hand it over to me. I will give you a peaceful death.
You are the Queen of the Netherworld? I am the Prince of Titania. I do not know why I am here. I would like you to return me to the living world.
Once you enter this land, you cannot be allowed to leave. Whoever you are is irrelevant. Your careless existence makes you want to leave. This is the land of the dead. Once you taste death, you will appreciate it.
So much careful work went into crafting her, the way that her dress is animated. It's kind of impressive. I mean, everything about the visuals of this game is pretty impressive, but the dress is crazy. Because it's all 2D, so like they had to do frame by frame to make it look like it's flowing cloth. Oh, that's a bummer. Whoa, that was a really cool way to end that attack. Ooh, toxin. Any other treasure on the floor for me? Cub's Bane. Is that the boss over here? Sure is. Hi! I gotta say, if I'm gonna defeat the Queen with as the Pooka Prince, it's really gonna nullify the, it's gonna somewhat reduce the victory that Gwendolyn had for in her final battle, if I take her out now in the as the first boss. She must not die, though, because there was something very final about her defeat with Gwendolyn that seemed like a really big deal, but this... Like, if we destabilize the entire Netherworld in the opening chapter, this is going to be a really weird story. So maybe she just lets me go. Like, I have to just prove myself or something. Ow. Hey, now. No more of you guys, please. So many undead. There you are. Oh, she went all scythe leg on me. But it only did, like, 6 damage, so it's not... the biggest threat at the moment. Let's try the pogo attack. Oh my god, you really can just keep going on. You can just keep going at it for a while. Nah, it looks like only 3 of them land, and then you end up going past them. Hey, buddy. I like my pow attacks. I don't know if you noticed that. It's one way to make sure you get behind her in time if you think she's gonna attack you. Oh, 4 attacks! New record! I pogoed her boobs.
Fine. Go if you wish. Even if you leave here, you will enter the Demon Lord's domain. The Valkyrie that serve that man are always searching for trespassers. They will capture you. You may wail in futility, but I must inform you. Those who are placed in the Netherworld while alive are sinners facing my judgment. Such people never find peace, even after death. They are destined to be torn apart by ghosts and shall forever wander the land. You will join them.
But I was not sent here. I have not sinned or committed any crime. I merely woke up and found myself here. Queen of the Netherworld, I shall go. Allow me to prove to you that this is some mistake.
Your short life is a dream. Death shall awaken you. Your sword has prolonged it. Your soul shall never rest. The Pooka shall stay afloat with a candle and light the way across the desolation. Prepare yourself.
So I have escaped the Netherworld. But as the Queen had warned, I soon became a prisoner of the Demon Lord.
New skill. So we're going to be meeting up with the Valkyries pretty soon here. All things considered, they're not really the most, despite starting out on their team, they're not really the most encouraging group. Electric shot that will dizzy foes. That's bound to be handy. Let's get some of these basic upgrades up. We only have a few skills to pick from, so it'll help out with our early missions. We're going to want to upgrade the cipher itself. Especially with its low starting cost, we could probably upgrade it twice. Oh yeah, we can afford that. Yeah, I like this guy's moveset so far. He's fun to control. Can't afford any more upgrades for now, though. And so we withdraw. See you guys next time.